version. It's a little bit different, but firstly, I want to acknowledge our country, of course. I want to show our respect and acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the elders past and present, on which this event takes place. A bit of housekeeping, just the toilets, if you are asking, just up the back there, just into the corridor. That's where they are, that's the most important thing. Don't have to turn it around where it's made. That's pretty good. Now, chairman of the ARLC, WA, Bob, can I pick up and say a few words, please, Bob?
Thank you, Sally, and good evening all, and welcome to Greg's night of nights. It's the night when we acknowledge and honour those who have reached the pinnacle in the many facets of our great game.
Named after the late Ken Allen, whose dedication and commitment not only to his beloved Frio Roosters but to the broader game in Western Australia epitomised all that is good about rugby league people. Tonight may appear a little less grand than the Ken Allen night in years past, but despite the challenges of 2020, our spirit is undaunted, and we're here to celebrate another very successful year of rugby league in Western Australia. That success didn't happen by magic, and I stand here in awe of the wonderful people, the rugby league people, whose courage, hard work and dedication made our game happen this year. The men and women, the boys and girls who trained hard and played their hearts out every week to bring so much enjoyment to those of us watching games. The parents, the coaches, the myriad of volunteers who selflessly gave their time. The club officials and the match officials. And of course our wonderful sponsors who have stood by us even though many of them were doing it tough as well this year. Speaking of doing it tough, I must commend Carissa Morrell and the crew at the Ellenbrook Rabbitohs for the way that they have steered their club this year through the tragic loss of two very fine people. And I hope they're able to draw some comfort from winning the premiership in the women's tackle competition. That team, of course, was captained by our beloved GDO, Kayleigh Thompson, an outstanding young woman whose strength and compassion I know have been a great help to the club. I'm proud to be a member of the rugby league family in Western Australia. I'm particularly proud of the magnificent crew at our head office. The game owes them a lot, and so do I. John Saxon, Tony Crow, Barbara Ann Woolley, not Barbara Ann Taylor, as she used to be, and the mighty Caleb Reedy, himself a former winner of the Ken Allen Medal, have put in hours and hours of unpaid work this year without any complaint and just a determination to keep our game afloat. And then, of course, there are the GDOs. There's Gus Marshall, who kicked the winning goal to give the Joondalup Giants this year's flag. But Gus and his GDO team have kicked a lot more goals than that for the game throughout the year. Gus and Kayleigh, Angus Street and Caitlin Miller have done a magnificent job in spreading the word and bringing new disciples to our great game. Now Caitlin, of course, has gone off to produce another rugby league player, and we've been very lucky to get Benton Scott in as a maternity leave replacement for her. So we wish her all the very best. I'm not sure whether it'll be a boy or a girl, but it doesn't matter these days. Rugby league welcomes everyone to play the game. And finally, I just want to thank all of you for coming here tonight. It is, as I always say, a night of celebration. So I'm going to celebrate, and I'm going to have a good time, and I hope you all do too. Thank you very much. Thank you, Bob. I'd now like to call our GM up, our General Manager, NRL WA, John Saxon.
Thank you, Sully, and thank you, Chairman Bob Cronin, and welcome all. And further to what Bobby has just said, thank you for attending this evening. It's not our usual bells and whistles, Kennellan medal presentation, but certainly no less important in its purpose and its significance in the history of the game in Western Australia. Firstly, a very special welcome to the Allen family, represented tonight by Kevin and Deborah Allen, and also their daughter Tanea. So welcome, Allen family. And a very special mention, hot off the press, a bit of a scoop here that Kevin Allen was last night at the Fremantle Roosters AGM made a life member of that particular club. So well done, Kevin. As touched on by Chairman Bobby Cronin, this has certainly been an unprecedented and unforgettable year for our rugby league community, our nation, and indeed the world in general. We've all had to confront many challenges as 2020 has unfolded, and it has been a remarkable feat by our code to collectively navigate our way through this year in such a successful manner. On behalf of NRL WA, I would like to thank all of our clubs, players, referees, judiciary members, and all the volunteers, not just in the metro region, but also statewide, from the Pilbara and the Kimberley in the northwest to Albany and the Great Southern. To each and every one of you, a massive thank you from NRL WA. Your cooperation and collaboration through the season has been greatly appreciated, particularly at times when we really felt that we questioned whether we were even going to be able to salvage a season in 2020, but we did. Actioning the COVID-19 protocols has not been an easy task for all of us, but you've all gone about it in a very responsible and very determined way, and for that we are truly grateful. It made our jobs a hell of a lot easier. It has been especially rewarding to reflect on some of the highlights from this season, notably the Junior Grand Final day hosted by the Willoughby Bears Rugby League Club at their newly refurbished ground at Weber Reserve. A fantastic day of junior football and very, very well conducted by the Willoughby Bears Rugby League Club. And what about that extraordinary Smarter Than Smoking Premiership Grand Final hosted by North Beach Rugby League Club up at Blue Force Reserve. Battled out for 106 minutes that game before Joondalup Giants eventually won their first grade grand final in 20 years against a very, very courageous Rockingham Sharks club. Outstanding, what an amazing way to cap off this year. It was very, very fitting. This evening, we'd also like to express our sincere gratitude, as Bobby touched on, to all of our loyal partners and sponsors who've stood by us through this really challenging year, when a lot of our sponsors could have found reason to perhaps not support us given the circumstances, but they did. And I just want to make mention of our sponsors and partners. Healthway, through our Smarter Than Smoking message, and a particular special welcome to an old friend of mine, Kira Berry. So representing Healthway tonight, Kira, fantastic to see you, and thanks for coming along. Cash Converters, the wonderful man Peter Cummins. This is the 11th consecutive year that Cash Converters have supported us at NRL WA with our game here, and they're part of the fabric of rugby league in this state. So Peter, to you, Nerida, Sarah, all the team, thank you. DLGSC, the Department of Local Government, Sport and Cultural Industries, for not only their funding support, but also their guidance and advice they gave us through the pandemic. It was invaluable to us, and our gratitude to them. Consolidated Energy, Julian Ambrose, who's been with us now 4 years, I think, Consolidated Energy, a wonderful partner. They ask for little and they give a lot to us. So our gratitude there. All Flags, Signs and Banners, very loyal partners of ours. Peter and Rhonda Wagner are here tonight. And they're the major sponsor of Women's Rugby League in Western Australia. So Peter, Rhonda, and to all your wonderful staff, thank you. Lion Brewing, Michael Galpin, a great friend of ours, and the fine beer product you're drinking tonight is from Lion, and I must say that at Byron Bay Lager, it's a good drop, mate, so very good. DDH1 Drilling, proud supporters of our referees. Matty Thurston is here tonight. You can't miss him, he's about 6'8". Where is he? He's out there somewhere. Hey, Matty. And thank you, Maddie, for your support. Fleetwood and ISS, Dominic Letts and Paul Archer over here. The guys give us incredible support up in the Pilbara region in particular. Again, they don't ask for much, that they give us a lot when we need it and really help our game develop up there in the Pilbara. It's a rugby league stronghold for us, and it's gonna get a lot stronger. So guys, thank you. Also acknowledging our on-field apparel partners, ISC and Strutties. And of course, our media partners. It's tough going in this town to get media support for our code, particularly when we haven't got a sexy elite franchise here at this point. But these guys just help us and help us in every possible way they can when we ask them to. And I want to make special mention for Mix 94.5, represented tonight by Erica McGee, great rugby league fan, Erica, so thank you. The regional Triple M and Hit Radio Network, represented tonight by Ian Kennedy, a former chairman of NRLWA, and also Chris Hall, a great supporter of ours, so guys, thank you. The Sunday Times and the Australian sports, Sunday Times sports editor, Glenn Quatermain, another great friend of the games here, and just love his company, terrific bloke, Glenn Quatermain, and also Mark Skeeter Reddings, the legend from Seven, and Skeeter's here too, a good Queensland supporter. Also want to make special mention of local media services company tonight, Dave McRae and his team, who are live streaming this event tonight, and of course they live stream our Cash Converters Match of the Round every week. And it goes through NITV nationally every week on a Tuesday night through both the SBS and the Foxtel platforms, which does wonderful things for our game to try and expose it more around this country. So thank you to Local Media Services Company. Guys, also tonight we'd like to acknowledge our life members who have built the foundations of our game over our proud 71-year history. I know that there's a number of life members here tonight. One in particular, Tony Vickers, is here tonight. And of course, people like Rod Fielding, and I'm sorry if I overlook other people, but to all life members who are in the room tonight, thank you for everything you've done for our game over the years. And also, we want to remember from our rugby league community, there's a number of people that have passed over the last, over recent times. All will be painfully missed, but will always be remembered for their involvement and contribution to the game they loved. Gone but never forgotten. Finally, I would like to thank Chairman Bobby Cronin for his support, his friendship, his good humour, and for being there in the trenches with us every week. Bobby, thank you. And to our incredibly passionate, dedicated and hardworking team at NRLWA. They're my team and they're your team. And they're out there doing it 24/7, 365, I can assure you. Even as Bob pointed to during the COVID situation where everyone was stood down, but they were still working, trying to keep the game afloat and keep it alive and keep it relevant. So to Crowey, to Barbara Ann, to Caleb, to Gus, Kaylee, Streedy, Caitlin, and Brenton, We all share a common goal, and that is to help rugby league grow and prosper here in WA. And we're already well and truly deep into planning for our 2021 season. We hope that we can get back to some normality next year. I think we will. But in the meantime, tonight, enjoy the evening, have some fun, and Sully, let's get into these awards. So thank you.
Thank you, John. Yes, as you said, we will start. We're going to, as you said, it's trimmed down a little bit our awards, but we will start with the Women's League tag. And our sponsor, the Regional Triple M and Hit Radio Network. I'd love Chris Hall to come up. Hawley loves doing this one every year. Don't drop that trophy, Hall. How are you, mate?
Never have, Sully.
Go on. Go on, you always.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of, we were originally Red FM for those that are here this evening, and we were fortunate enough to be purchased by SCA, which is Southern Cross Stereo, and we are now Triple M and Hit throughout Region WA, having 40 stations. We are so proud to be part of Rugby League in WA. It's a forging sport. I'm an AFL man, I'm first to admit that, but no, it's okay. You can have a crack. But NRL is as forging its way into WA, and hopefully one day, Sacco, where are you, mate? We will have a team over here. I don't know what you want to call it, Sacco's Raiders or the Pirates. But congratulations to everyone in this room tonight that have survived through COVID and the challenges that it has provided to everyone in this room. Like, we've learnt new things, we've gone different ways, but it's all onwards and forwards. And we are so proud to present this trophy tonight. Thanks very much. Cheers.
Well, without further ado, the Regional Triple M and Hit Radio Network Player of the Year from the South Perth Lions, Kaylee Wallace. Where are you going? Come here. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well done. I must admit, it's one thing, obviously, coaching the juniors on a Thursday night, and you see this girl get down to train at about 5:30. They don't train till 6:30, and she's doing extras all the time. And this is probably the last time we're going to see you in WA for a little while, eh?
For sure. Yeah? Yes, I'm heading to the Air Force, so it'll be my last season. It was very special, so... Yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately, obviously, grand final day was a wonderful year, but you just couldn't get the grand final win, but still doesn't knock back the great teammates, and obviously, Shawnee, your coach, and it's been a good season.
For sure. Very good thankful for my teammates, and for Sean and Ange, and Paul Hudson, and everyone that helped out. So, yeah.
Yeah, well, our future's going well with you in the Air Force. Good girl. Ladies and gentlemen, our lead tag player of the year, Kaylee Wallace. Our next award is the Val Murphy Trophy. 20th of March 2020 was a sad day for a lot of us who have been involved in rugby league, not only here, but Papua New Guinea, who knew this great man, Val Murphy. It was the day that Val passed away. Obviously, with no third grade this year, it was the logic thing to do was just combine the third grade and the reserve grade. And it was the Val Murphy Trophy. I called it the Val Murphy Reserve Grade Trophy all year, I think, and when I was talking things. For those that remember Val, and we used to see him, you know, all the time, and he's done everything here and for the game. It was the least we could do, and all NRLWA could do was obviously just lift it up to that next level. We miss Val. A lot of us who used to see him every year, especially Grand Final Day, used to see him come down. He was just so proud to present trophies to whoever he was told to do. So I'd love our sponsor from Mix 94.5, Erica McGee, to come up if she could, please. Coming through the crowd there. I think you've got to go. Yeah, good girl. Thank you. The winner of the Mix 94.5 Player of the Year actually won the Ken Allen Medal in 2019. It's from the North Beach Seagulls, Deborah Cook. Come on, mate, just quickly. Who'd have ever thought you'd be back up here? 2009, you win the Ken Allen Medal. We moved to 2020, you win the Reserve Grade Player of the Year.
Yeah. appreciate for the award, eh, and humble. Yeah, it's like, thanks North Beach for giving me an opportunity to play for their club. And, congrats to all the team that made finals, and big congratulations for the ones who won.
Mate, you've finished off the year. You got the Wally Stein.
Oh yeah.
Player of the year. Player of the grand final. And
yeah.
And you know, I forgot myself during. You know, we waited and just had to get the trophy back up again. And just the emotion on your face. And I've just mentioned Val Murphy as well.
Yep.
So yeah, you're very, very proud of that fact, aren't you?
Yeah. No, it was good to get the man of the match. Or, you know, like the trophies I got, like, you know, dedicated to special people, and yeah, they're not no longer here with us, but yeah, so very honoured to receive the award. Yeah,
well done, mate. Cheers. Congratulations. Yep. Thank you very much. We move on now to the Women's Tackle Award. I love our sponsor from All Flag Signs and Banner, Peter Wagner, to come up, please. The All Flag Signs and Banners Player of the Year from the Ellenbrook Rabbitohs, Kaylee Thompson. Hello, KT.
Hello, Sally.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, really good. Congratulations. Caps off, you know, I know trophies and everything, but I dare say the big thing was grand final day, wasn't it?
Mm.
Just grabbing that grand final win.
Yeah, definitely. We had a bit of a tough year. We were struggling a little bit for numbers, which was a little bit crazy, thinking we were back-to-back premiers. But, yeah, it was probably the hardest year we've had so far. So Fremantle Roosters gave it to us all year, so we just knew we had to turn up and play really hard, and I think we did on the day.
Yeah, well, that's right. And you just, as I said, the emotion on the girls and the coach and staff and all the supporters, it was a highlight of the day.
Yeah, it was. It was something, if I'm honest, I couldn't see really midway of the season happening for us. So for it to come true, we worked really, really hard. So yeah, for that final sort of blow, and we'd won the game, it was something we loved, and I think we're going to remember for a very long time.
One thing before you go, Women's Rugby League.
Yes.
You've been there since the start, and we'll just talk about these two girls that are in the New South Wales Blues side, the game on Friday night.
Yeah.
Two local WA girls in Shanice Parker. Shanice has been named on the wing today. Kennedy is, Kennedy in Cherrington was in the 20, she hasn't been named in the 17, but for, it must be a massive thing for young kids now to be able to look, say, well, there's two girls from WA. We can do it.
Mm. Yeah, 100%. Just to see the pathways that we have here as a combined affiliated states is fantastic. And to see that the final product being Shanice and Kennedy making it to that big stage is fantastic. And a credit to all their hard work throughout the years. So we can play rugby league over here in WA, and we can definitely make those pathways as well, which is very exciting.
That's the one. Just remember, we do play rugby league in the West.
We do.
Well done, our women's tackle player of the year, Kaylee Thompson. Our All Flag Signs and Banners, yes. Next one's a very important one. It's our Volunteers of the Year. The Government of WA, Department of Local Government, Sports and Cultural Industries is sponsors this one, but unfortunately none of them could be here tonight. But we have Dominic Letts from Fleetwood ISS, who's going to come up and help me. He's going to be busy. As Bob and John both said, throughout 2020 especially, I think the grind got hard, and volunteers. I know a lot of them worked their butts off, and it wasn't just one or two. It was numerous types of volunteers. Our female volunteer of the year, the work undertaken over the last few years with their committee and the overall work for the club and the dedication of junior players has been a revelation at this one club. All their hard work was justified in a junior grand final, which I was a losing coach on the other side. So it was one of those ones where we saw the Kalamunda Bulldogs win the under-15s grand final, and you just said, good on them. But this lady, she's done a lot of hard work. She is the female volunteer of the year from the Kalamunda Bulldogs, Rebecca Foster. Okay, no worries. Well done. No, don't go yet. Oh, yeah, here's another one. Yeah. Now, our male volunteer of the year. He assists in all roles of this club, both juniors and seniors. He's assisted NRLWA on game days at every function, I don't know for how long. You see him running around and having a chat to everybody, and everyone says, who's this bloke? Who's this bloke? But the more you see him, the more he keeps turning up. He just loves rugby league. From the Mandurah Storm, Michael McKenzie. Well done, mate. A little bit different this year. We've added one in. It's called the. It's a family. Volunteer of the year. NRLWA, as we're saying, it's been a tough year, but they decided to acknowledge a family. This family, their roles with not only the Rockingham Sharks as registers, coaching, assisting with the Southwest Dolphin in regional competitions. They give everything. They do everything. You always see them. They ring up and even. Occasionally, when we need a sideline expert with a microphone, he jumped in. This year, the family from the Rockingham Sharks, Brett and Joe McMillan. Congratulations to all our volunteers, not just the prize winners, of course. Our Players Award, we started this last year, I think, with Caleb Reedy, went around all the clubs and got votes, and I'd like our sponsor from Cash Converters, Peter Cummings, to come up and help me. So our Women's Players Player of 2020, from the Fremantle Roosters, Katarina Horner. The Men's Players Player from the Joondalup Giants, Kanaya Gudgeon. He just thinks he's... Now time to move on to our respective club championships awards. The Healthway Smarter Than Smoking competitions, and I'd love from Healthway, Kira Berry, to come up and help me, please. Thank you. Firstly, the senior club champions. The 2020 senior club champions are the Joondalup Giants. Come on, Johnsy, come on. Come to Sully, just quickly. Yeah, I know, Kira won't mind waiting. Mate, congratulations. Obviously, a wonderful year of senior footy. Fantastic. Culminating in, that grand final.
Yeah, was there a grand final? I don't know. Gus, was there a grand final? Was there a grand final?
But obviously, just the whole way, obviously winning grand finals, it's other sides as well, and your reserve grade were unbelievable for, what, four-fifths of that year, weren't they?
I think we had at one stage undefeated teams in virtually almost every senior grade. The culture change from last year to this year's that's been noticeable on the field. It's been fantastic for a long time. Giants like myself and others to see that hard work and dedication on the field and behind the scenes can pay off and actually have on-field results for a change.
Absolutely. Well, congratulations, mate. Enjoy.
Thank you, Sally.
Back up in 2021. Now, our Smarter Than Smoking Club Champions, which is a combination of juniors and seniors. The 2020 Smarter Than Smoking Club Champions, the South Perth Lions. Congratulations, Bruce. Obviously, if you look, the juniors 4 in grand finals and the seniors 2 in grand finals, and obviously 0-6, as in winning them. But yep. That's footy. Yep. That's the basic way. That's it, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's obviously every club tries to make grand finals or win grand finals, but there's only ever been one winner, and the juniors really obviously helped us get over there with their having a very, very strong year for the juniors this year. So obviously, seniors, we probably would have finished quite a few points behind Joondalup in the seniors, but the juniors had a very strong year. So I guess this really is from the efforts of the juniors throughout 2020. They had a good year. Yeah.
Oh, well. That's what it's all about. One team.
Yep.
Thank you very much. Cheers. Now to the Strutties Team of the Year. This year, a little bit different. Just one player in one position, so 9 players. 9 players only. And I'd love from the Sunday Times, Glenn Quatermain, to come up and hand these jerseys over to the players. G'day, mate. In trouble already, Quarters. Firstly, for our Team of the Year, the fullback from the Joondalup Giants, Kanoa Gudgeon. Wanted to stay up here, don't you? Okay. No. Our winger, number 2 in the Strutties Team of the Year, from the Joondalup Giants, Luke Turner.
Yeah.
Our centre, number 4, from the Joondalup Giants, Ringy Kingy. Now 5'8", the number 6, from the South Perth Lions, Eddie Proudler. Now halfback, the number 7, from the Rockingham Sharks, Tyler Hunt. Now prop, the number 8, from the Joondalup Giants, Nathan Searle. The hooker, the number 9, from the Rockingham Sharks, Andrew Jeffrey. Our second rower, the number 12, from the South Perth Lions, Mason Hicko. And our lock, the number 13, from the South Perth Lions, Jared Smith. And the Strutties, Coach of the Year, from the Joondalup Giants, John Harbin. I'll get all the boys back up, please, just for a team photo, if we possibly could. Thank you, Quartz. Cheers, mate. Well, we're now down to the furlong, as they say in horse racing terms. We haven't got long to go. I'd now love if I could invite the Allen family, and if Kevin could come up. I'm not sure if the girls are coming up as well, but no. Kevin's coming up, and Tanea, of course. That'd be wonderful. Mate, congratulations on that life membership.
Thanks.
Great
stuff. Yeah.
Well done. You really deserve that.
Thank you.
Yeah, because all jokes aside, if you're ever down at the Roosters, these are the people you see all the time, and Mrs. Allen, of course, and running around and doing a great job, so well deserved. Mate, the microphone's yours for a minute.
All right. Thank you. What do I do with glasses?
You want mine?
Could be a quick night. Thanks. Thank you, Tanea. No incorrect jokes tonight, so I'll make it fairly quickly, given it's a COVID year. Everything has to be summarised this year, doesn't it? Look, I'd just like to thank the NRLWA for continuing with this tradition of the Ken Allen Award. It's from the family. It's very, very much appreciative. It's an evening for all, normally. And it's great to see so many people even here this evening. So thank you to again for to the NRLWA for hosting the event. And I'd also like to thank all the volunteers, the administrators, and in particular the spouses, the partners that we have for allowing us to put the amount of time that we do into to this game. And just on that particular note, thanks very much, John and Sully, for acknowledging that I was fortunate enough to be able to become a life member of the Fremantle Rugby League Club. But you can't do these sort of things if you don't have the support of your family. So from that perspective, I'd really like to thank my family for allowing me the all that time to be able to put into the club. So thank you. Whilst we are congratulating, I would like to congratulate both the Joondalup and Rockingham clubs for the grand final. For those of you who were there, it was a cracker of a game. It was a really, really good game, and as I think someone said, 106, 108 minutes. I think that demonstrates that it was a good game. As I say, thank you very much for being able to be here tonight to present this. I'll leave it at that and just... I'm not sure what we're going to do next. Are we going straight into it? Or are we...
You just stand there for a minute.
Yep.
And then... Now I'll invite John Saxon back up to the stage to announce the leaderboard at the end of round 12.
Thanks, Sully and Kevin. So normally when we do these Ken Allen medal presentations in the boardroom, we go through every round pretty well. But like everything else tonight and this year, you know, it's an abbreviated version. So what we're going to do is we're going to go straight into the leaderboard at the conclusion of round 12 of the Smarter Than Smoking Premiership. And after round 12, the leaderboard looked like this. Andrew Jeffrey, Rockingham Sharks, on 13 points. Kanoa Hudgen, Joondalup Giants, on 12 points. Eddie Proudler, South Perth Lions, on 9. Jared Smith, South Perth Lions, on 7. Nathan Searle, Joondalup Giants, on 6 points. Tyler Hunt, Rockingham Sharks, on 6. Mason Hiko, South Perth Lions, on 6. And Lee Tamari of the Joondalup Giants, on 6. That took us into round 13, the final round of the season. And South Perth had the bye that round. There were two fixtures, which would prove to play a key role in determining this year's Ken Allen medalist. Rockingham Sharks versus North Beach Sea Eagles. 1 point went to Hayden Wood, Rockingham Sharks. 2 points went to Reese Potter, Rockingham Sharks. And 3 points went to Quinton Fui, Rockingham Sharks. The other game was Fremantle Roosters hosting the Joondalup Giants. 1 point went to Bjorn Crotty of the Fremantle Roosters. 2 points went to Gus Marshall of the Joondalup Giants, and 3 points went to Kanoa Gudgeon of the Joondalup Giants. So guys, people who are doing their maths out there will clearly determine that the winner of the 2020 Smarter Than Smoky Premiership Kennellan Medal for this year is Kanoa Gudgeon.
Yeah, you can come and have a chat now. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
COVID and no Queensland Cup was the Joondalup Giants in the NRLW's game, WA's game this year, mate. Obviously, for those who don't know Kanoa's story, he's debuted for South Perth back in 2015, went to the Newcastle Knights for 2 years, played under 20s at the 2016, 2017, 2018, he was Q Cup at Tweed Seagulls. And then last year was at the Central Queensland Capras. And as I said, no Q Cup. And his partner's a WA girl. And they came home. So how's it been, mate?
Oh, yeah. Firstly, I just want to thank NRLWA for putting on the season and all the hard work you guys had to do and all the major sponsors as well. I know it couldn't have been an easy feat, but we got to the end of the season and I think everyone enjoyed the season, and I think that's a testament to what you guys put together and had to work through. So yeah, firstly I'd just like to thank you guys and everyone that made this season possible. It's good to be back in Perth, playing against blokes that I grew up idolising, also playing with in the juniors as well. And seeing familiar faces and getting that love of the game back, that's probably been the most enjoyable part of being back in WA.
At the start of the year, we all saw a five-team competition, and I must admit myself, I said it a number of times, five teams, but you wouldn't know from week to week who'd turn up and could be. I personally thought, obviously, North Beach, tough year, but the other four teams, you can win on any time of the week. You were involved in a lot of them. Did you notice that yourself?
The competition was really tough. If that grand final game didn't tell you enough, I think, every team was really tight. I think at a stage there was maybe three or four of us that could have been on top. That's how close the competition was. And, it was really close.
Mate, well, it's been wonderful to have you back. And obviously, Joondalup enjoyed it. You've not only won an NRLWA Premiership, you're now a prestigious NRLWA Kennellan Medal winner. Our winner, Kanoa Gudgeon. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's come to that evening. Once again, thank you for the opportunity to MC our prestigious Kennellan Medal night.